Hello, welcome to Generation Zero. First of all, I just want to mention that I have been following this game for a few weeks or months even. I've read about it and I've seen a lot of videos of it, and I have to say, everything was misleading. When the game came out, it was nothing like people expected, because as you know, they tend to forget certain details of the game. So if you want the short version, the game is not worth its price right now, and I'll tell you why it's not worth the price, why it's such a great game and what can other developers learn from it, and how it can be fixed. But first, let's start the game. And yeah, the character customization ends in about 1 minute maximum. It's basically the same guy, but he's either uglier or prettier. So it's your choice. Skin tone, A and B, not a lot. No, he looks like a guy who can actually win the game, or actually, if this was a B movie, he would survive the movie. He would not survive the movie, but he would die in a glorious way. Anarchy sign. By the way, this is in the 80s, 1980s, in Sweden. And that's great, I have to say, that's a great idea. I like his pants, by the way, and his jacket. Okay, let's stop admiring him. He looks like the guy who'll die first in a B horror movie. He looks like... kind of looks like Jarvis, I don't know. Yeah, he kind of does look like Jarvis from Halloween. Anyway, let's move on. He looks... anyway, let's stop doing that, because you don't have a lot of options in the game and you have to improvise. So you have two styles for each. He looks like a guy from Warriors. Okay, I'll just choose the Greaser because I like the Fallout universe, and he... actually, he's a rebel. Hardcore Overload. Yeah, he's very overpowered. You don't want style too. Okay, so as you can see, this is a multiplayer game. And it has a multiplayer function, but at the same time, this is what they did wrong. Okay, as the poor red... yeah, deals with Hitler. This is the story. A big problem of this game is this could have been one of the best single player games ever made. I mean, this could have been like Metro. This could have been like a Stalker. This could have been, I don't know, like a single player Fallout. This could have been so many great things, but... unfortunately... yeah... it shows a wrong path. I mean, it's a single player game where you start in 1989. That... where you fight... I'm sorry, I'm just having problem thinking of a good way to describe the game. Where you start out as in something desperate. This is your mission log. This is what... what will guide you through the game. There are no NPCs, there are no clear mission markers, there is nothing that will help you. It does that when I press shift. I hate that thing. So there is nothing clear to indicate how you progress in the game. And now I'll speak about the bad things. See this huge map? Well, you travel by foot, so this can take you literally hours. Hours of just going through the motions. Hours of you just going with a friend, or I don't know if you can play with a friend, because this game will get so boring that they'll just quit. To be honest, I'll just have to say another thing. I received this game for free from a friend, a streamer friend, LMG, that's his name. And I won a contest to receive this key. To be honest, as you can see from here, the game is actually very pretty and it's quite atmospheric and it has one of the best settings you can get. So, you are surrounded by water, right? Can you swim? No, you can't swim. So, do you have vehicles? No. So you have to walk all around the map to actually find some bunkers, and after you find a bunker, well... that's about it. You go to another bunker, you go to another location, you go to another thing. Another thing that is really, really weak. Weapons 1, collectible 01. Is that the game has no sense of real progression. I mean, you you get so many items that it's not even hard to progress in the game. And I'm sorry to spoil the magic, but now let's get inside and I'll show you what I mean. By the way, if you die, you respawn in the same location. If you don't have an adrenaline syringe, if you have an adrenaline syringe, let's say you die in here, you might as well spawn like in here. If you die too many times, you'll actually respawn at a bunker, but all the enemies on all the ammunition respawns if you leave the game. So you basically don't win anything and you're invincible in the game. That's totally wrong. No penalties, no benefits to surviving for a long time, no nothing. So you're better off just running through the map and getting the best items and just running and running to the next bunker or location. And that's not fun at all. And the robots, which should be amazing, are actually some of the weakest parts of the game. Because there is not enough of them, they are not varied enough, they don't use different tactics, they don't upgrade as your character progresses. Yeah, they are very bad. So having received this game for free, I decided to try it. And I think the Steam reviews say it all in this case. But just to be sure, okay, that's all the negativity I want to say. Now let's play the game. This is one of the best starting in a game I ever seen. Come on, this game is like 10,000 creep factor. Look at this thing with its red light and its oil. It was shot, it was destroyed. And it's very menacing. And you don't have ammunition and you're scared. Is this a robot? Well, but we're in 1989. What happened? Look at the TV. Sonics. And then you have this thing. Does this break immersion enough for you? You press C, by the way. Yeah, so you have dances in a game that is so serious and so sinister and so horror looking. You have dances. Point. Okay, let's move on. Then you have this. You also can explore the locations a lot more and you can also press some switches. This is a bloody hand. So someone was left alive. I mean, it shot the robot, but it probably died. So you follow all these trails. That's a first aid kit, by the way. Let's see, we put it on the fourth slot. Do we have a flashlight in here? Yes. So let's turn on our flashlight. Let's take the binoculars. Let's assign them to 5 because I also want to show you the great elements that this game has. Again, you can press to light up the lamp. This is a slower part of the game, but don't worry, I'll just rush. After I finish this little house, I'll just rush the game a bit so you can see what I mean. But this is meant to be played slow, and if you play this slow, you actually get scared. I'm playing this during the night time and I'm actually feeling a little afraid of something, but I don't know what. There are robots, but are they controlled by people? Okay. And again, the story is that all the clocks stopped at 00. I don't know, do you have a way to tell what time it is right now? I don't know. And the more you search, the more you find things that are so out of place that it seems like, I don't know, aliens. Aliens have come. It's all part of the game. Okay, so that was the house. Don't ask me. Just don't ask me how I knew about that. A gnome. So I guess we have been gnomed. Gnomed. Anyway, I'm not sure how you see how many collectibles are left in this location or what can you do. So let's go to the police car, which is... Oh, I want to shoot that, and I'll shoot it. So this is basically a single player game that could have been great, mixed with a multiplayer survival mode which has no meaning at all and no sense of victory. And it's very interactive, by the way. It almost reminds me like Escape... Yeah, it reminds me of Escape from Tarkov. 0.32 ammo. And this pistol uses 0.32 ammo, right? How many bullets did you get? 120 bullets. The whole survival element and aspect of the game is just destroyed by this. You got so many bullets that you don't need anything. And then you see this destroyed robot here in the side of the car. This is amazing, I love this one. And let's try slowly walking. As you can see, it's almost day right now. But you get so many bullets that it just destroys some elements of the game. Let's have this little station right here. There's nothing in it. Also have this shack. Sorry about my English. I'm working on it. It's hard to pronounce sometimes when I'm disinvolved in a game. Okay, those are just some clothes. You can find... Another problem is... Let me see. Yeah, it's all cosmetic stuff. All the loot you can find in bags or... in some bags or in some backpacks like that or... I don't know, something like that. There's not really... Not a lot of interactive loot. To say it like that. I don't think I can open that. So I'll just search even more. So what is in this shack? Just another bicycle and no backpack. So that means I can't loot anything. What's in here? Nothing? It's a box. Okay, let's take everything. So now I'm just breaking up the game so you don't see... I mean, if you follow the questline, we should have killed the robot by now. So let's go and kill that robot. This is amazing. Look at this. This screams... It has so much life and art style poured into it that is not even funny. Okay, so the adrenaline shots is exactly what I mean. If you have an adrenaline shot and you die, you respawn exactly in the same 5 meter area with 20% HP. So let's see, you don't want to go to the car because you want to explore more. You are afraid of something. Right? Right? Well, we'll see. Sometimes you can see where the boxes are, because everything here is in a box. Who is this? Was this person part of the military? I've only been playing for a few minutes, and I have so much ammo. We can't open this, this can't By the way, did you hear that? That's a robot. You should be very afraid of them by now, because you don't know what they are or where they come from, but... Again, sorry for having to show you the bad part, but I'm not angry at the game. I received it for free from a friend. And I'll play it if it improves, and I'll play it to test some things, and I'll... play it even more to actually find out more about the story. So let's meet our first enemy. Look at that thing, that's amazing, the animations. And then you do this. This thing looks terrifying and at the same time it should scare you. let's do the robot. Oop. Right now I'm just outsmarting an AI which actually has a lot of weapons on him. That was a ram attack, by the way. Okay, let's let him kill me, please. Come on. Oh, fine, kill me now. I love it, it moves like a wild animal. And it has a shoulder-mounted pistol or machine pistol. Okay, we're dead. What happens when you die? You press enter, you revive. And I won that combat. And then you press 4 to use a first aid kit. And then you move on. Let's see, you can use also the binoculars. Again, this is a very good feature of the game. You can actually scout before you go into a location. How do you equip your pistol, by the way? It's not on one. Move item. How do you equip your pistol? This is a real question. I'm pressing all the... Oh, okay. And now let's move forward. Now that I have gotten the bad things out of the way, let me start by saying all the nice things. If you are stuck through the first part of the game, then you are genuinely interested in it. So let's start exploring and actually reach the next settlement or house or whatever you want to call it. Again, I won't be playing this for a very, very long time, so don't expect an hour video. No, let's stop being silly. That's a Walkman. As you can see, they're not that easy to kill if they don't rush to you. If they wouldn't do that, they were actually hard to kill. So you may think this was pretty cool, and so far we have seen two robots and they're both terrifying. And the UI is pretty clean and it has everything you need. And you just have to follow the road. I mean, there is no living person to be seen right here. Kind of like Fallout 76, no NPCs, no living person. Well, Fallout 76 did have that mutant, Graham, or whatever he was called. Again, so much ammunition out of a normal car. They give you too much items, that's part of the problem. And look at this robot. He seems very different. He's an android, a robot that has a human appearance. Okay, so he has found in the direction. We need to find the equipment. Follow the road to look for a safe place. There is no safe place in the apocalypse. And this was where the hard part begins. You have almost no markers, you have no idea where you are. And you are still in the fun part of the game. These are all locked. And I have to press shift. I mean, as far as I know, there is no way to toggle those things. Run. I mean, I want to toggle run, I want to toggle... the sight of the pistol of the weapon. And I don't think I have any options. If I have any options for that, I'm sorry. Okay, so now we'll fight again the mighty robots. Let's just heal up. I want to be 100% for this. Just look how terrifying they are. They react to you so fast. So they actually fire at you when they sight you. And it's very easy to see when you hit them, and there are a lot of them right here. And it's a lot easier to aim without the sights, by the way. Come on, what are you? Is that a grasshopper? But since you can see them all around you with that little menu thing, it's a bit easier to see them. Oh, come on, stop doing that. As I said, I like their animal behavior, like that, when they behave like this. Okay, let's kill this one fast. But they just stop in front of you like that and you can shoot them. They are very easy to learn, I mean, they have a set behavior. And the loot is always the same. Which is kind of disappointing. Yes, I won another combat. Is that a thing I can use? No. Okay. So you may think we are out of first aid kits, we have limited resources. Oh no, what will we do? What will happen to us? And then you get to this part. You have a mission and you have collectibles and you have all that stuff to search, right? So let's roleplay this a bit. By now you should be very scared. Again, the same boxes in the same shacks with the same assortment of ammunition. And that's about it, right? There's nothing in here except for that box. You don't need food, you don't need anything else, you just need more bullets. And adrenaline shots, of course, and small items like that. I mean, they could have at least added something like a food and water meter, just for the fun of it. What do you think there will be in here? More ammunition. Again, I have over 100 ammunition again. A radio. Another backpack with ammunition, fireworks and flares, all kind of things. Because this is centered around multiplayer. And if you'd start the game with a friend, it would have been not two times easier, but about 10 times easier. To be honest, I know how churches are made, so I can go up. And here we should find some kind of a room or special thing, right? Here we can go all the way to the top. And this is your first big weapon, right? And it's a pump shotgun. And this thing just destroys. Okay, let's heal up. By the way, the items, after you use all of them, you just have to re-equip them. By the way, I'm pressing 4 and then I have to press click. Left click, that is. Okay, so I guess that was everything in here. But wait, we have still more ammunition to take. Okay, so now I'll actually start being a little more prepared for the game and actually roleplay it a bit. I mean, I still have about 5 minutes left, so now I'll just focus on the good part of the game. What do you mean I still have a mission in here? What is my mission? See, that's what I mean. The hunter. Okay, now I have to go to their house. But it still says I have something to take from the church. And I have no idea what I have to take from the church, because this is a mission and I don't want to fail it. Guess what? More ammunition and more cosmetic stuff for your character to wear. And they all pop up again like that. What do you want from me, game? What do I have to pick up from here? Yeah, this is the part where I don't really understand, and I'm not playing dumb right now. Search the church for anything of interest left behind. Is this it? Did I find everything? Oh no, I missed a backpack again. First aid kits, flares and all that stuff. Maybe I did forget something. What I get? I got the ammunition, I got the shotgun. Yeah, this should be everything. Okay, I'm leaving this place. And this is where the game gets a little tedious. Are you happy now, game? Of course he's not happy with me. So if you shoot your weapons outside of a building or something like that in an open space, you'll alert the robots. Oh, it's a dead guy here. So the same robots come after you, but wait. This time we are prepared, right? So you just die, get up again, and shoot them in the face. Of course, they all have the pistol ammunition. And then you do all of this again. Of course, your first aid kits are not selected on 4. And I still don't understand what the game wants me to do in the church, right? But I'll try to humor it and... Okay, let's search for all the loot that is available in here. So the robots are not really made to maintain the atmosphere, they're just made to have something to shoot at and something that will shoot at you. Come on, game, what more do you want for me? Don't tell me that I had to search this particular backpack. Okay, there are still some loot left. At this point, I'll just give up, because I don't think this is a mission that I have to finish like that. I've searched the church, but do I have to finish all the mini objectives like that? I'm pretty sure there is some loot left in here too. Oh, can I disable that motion blur, by the way? Oh. Oh, this is amazing right now. I love it without the motion blur. Anything hidden in here? Nope. So at this point I'll just give up and go to the next location. But where is the next location, you may wonder? Well, let's go to the other one, right? But it seems it still wants me to search for something in the church, but I don't want to remain in the church. Okay, this is very rough on me. So, this is what the game wanted me to do. Should I be angry at that? Or should I be happy that I saw it? I don't know, it's basically your choice, but I'll just finish that other mission and then I'll call it quits. Yes, you may want to play more after you see this, but again, I'm just pretending I don't know how to play. Because I saw so many footage of the game that I actually know how to play the game better than I imagined. But I'm just not interested in playing it in this particular state, so to avoid spoiling some things, I'll just... I don't know, maybe I'll play it for a few more hours and then I'll stop playing. How do you equip the primary and the secondary weapon? Run, interact, free aim. Primary weapon is 1, sidearm is 3. Okay, so the pistol is on 3, but we'll just have to see what's next. We searched this already, right? Okay, let's remove that waypoint. I don't know how to view my own profile. Okay, so what mission are we doing again? This is... sometimes you just get... Okay, let's press track on that. Can I see that objective on my map, or is that just again? You don't know where to go, you don't know what to do, you just get attacked all the time by the robots. Location. Okay, nearby. Okay, so we're searching for a house and we came from that direction. Again, let's shoot our pistol. Well, this time no one comes for us. Well, this is bad. Now I have to do another video for this game, because in this game I didn't play the game so good and I just said a lot of things that maybe didn't make a lot of sense for people. Because you might get the idea that I've been only playing this game for a few minutes, right? Well, that's not exactly the case, but we'll just have to see what we find after this part. Again, this is kind of what the average player would do, because you don't have any idea that this is supposed to be a multiplayer game. Unless you just want to enjoy the single player experience. Okay, so the farm is in the west side of the map. Just look at the graphics and the art style, that's so good. And what do you think we'll find in here? Of course, enemies, ammunition, first aid and some total chaos and destruction. Again, this is the good part of the game. Loot, free collectibles, 1. So, what happened to the tank? So the army is actually fighting the robots with these tanks. Remember, you don't want to get flanked by the robots. And they purposely give you a weaker weapon so you get familiar with the combat. The gunplay is fantastic, by the way, it's fun. I can't hit anything, right? Don't do that. Okay, so you can just step in the middle of this interesting firefight to heal. And actually quite blend. They blend into the background. And they also use that tactic. But there is too many of them, I feel like. So you just have to run, hide behind cover. They'll continuously attack you and I'm out of first aid kits. Okay, let's run to some other cover. Come on, why don't you die? Their behavior is a little bit predictable, unfortunately. Okay, that one is very close to me. Oh, I killed it and it killed me. Okay, let's revive and let's continue. No, that was not the last one. Okay, that was a pretty interesting fight. To be honest, you don't even need to pick up the loot from them because you get many bullets for this gun. And again, if I had problems, I would just respawn. That was a collectible, I didn't even see what I pick up. If you are having problem, just exit the game and enter the game. Everything will be in place. You can loot everything again, get the same items, ammunition. Nothing really seems balanced in here. Because most people, when they show you this game, they just show you the part with the shooting, or the part with the horror elements, or the part with the graphic elements. Or some of the customization, and then again, you're stuck in the same situation. What are you doing here? What mission are you trying to accomplish? Okay, locate the farm. Okay, so this location was basically for us to pick up a collectible. We're still out of medkits, by the way. And once you enter your first big location, you won't have any problems with it. And again, this seems very, very strange. What happened here? I have one medkit, right? Can you use the medkit from here? I have no idea. Okay, let's find that farm. It still says we have to go west. I'm not giving up until I find that farm, and I'm not giving up until I show you more of the game. Again, this is real-time walking. This is the real movement speed you'd have. I really hope they modify the game a lot and they actually make this like more like a survival game with elements of panic, stress, I don't know, running for cover, avoiding combat. And of course something like a more survival oriented gameplay. Or you can actually find a few, I don't know, you shoot a deer, you take some meat from it, you just fry up some meat. And that's enough. And that's really enough. And again, there are many locations on the road, but again, if you search those locations, we'll probably get attacked. Yeah, that's what I mean. So why waste everything? Because you only gain a few points of experience, which you can use to get to use in your skills. Stamina amount. Of course, you can unlock these skills. Stamina. Chemist. But we want aim speed, or what is the other option? Yeah, reload speed. So let's go west. As I said, you can skip most of the encounters. You won't lose anything major or important. You still have your profile, your log, yeah, your team, and everything else. But again, this being a multiplayer game, most of the time you won't even feel like there is any difficulty to it. And once you learn how to fight those robots, well, that's basically game over. Stenga farm. So here you should find a lot of items. I don't feel like fighting you guys. Okay, that's enough fighting for one day. So what happens when you're in a house? Nothing? Again, the music says you're in combat and they are fighting you. Again, a lot of empty space, just empty space all around me. And nothing to loot, because as I said, if you don't find the backpacks or the crates, to err is human. To make errors is to be human, right? Or something like that. Let's turn off our flashlight. So what did you get from in this house? Nothing. So what do you have to do? Go outside and fight the robots. The hit markers on the robots are perfect and you can hear and also see when you hit them. And they do take a lot of bullets. And if all the combat was slow like this, I would have no problem with the game. But after one point, you just get bored of it. And of course you can cheese them like this, you just wait here and wait for them to come to you. Okay, two of them are down, I think. And they are a bit of a bullet sponge. And what are your options here again? Well, you only have one door, and I don't think you have a balcony. You can't open the windows. You can't shoot through the windows. So So you basically have to wait here until they die. Again, that stupid dance, it's on C. And I keep pressing C because I think it's my crouch button. So C, just have to... Oh. You're very close. To be honest, I don't even feel like picking up all the ammo because they just give you back the ammo you wasted on them. And they tell you to search for a hiding location or something like that. And here is your hiding location. This is what you get. First aid kits in backpacks. So imagine doing this for 2 hours or 3 hours or even 4 hours or 5 hours. Newspapers, more bullets of all types. What do you mean my inventory is full? Oh, so I have to drop stuff now, okay. Let's drop all the fireworks. So I can use that to make a diversion. Okay, let's do it anyway. Because you don't, you have to increase your inventory slots to do this. I almost forgot about those. That's cute. That's very cute. Okay, so that is actually very powerful. Oh, that was very fun. And what do you know, more radios. For you to avoid even more combat. Once again, you have to go into your inventory and equip the first aid kits. And that's about it. I'm sorry, this was a very long video and I didn't want it to be this long, but I just wanted to show you the first hour of gameplay. And let's check our notes, because after you complete a mission, you have to check the notes. You have to reach another location, you have to read something else, you have to check your map again. You have to go 1 kilometer this direction on foot again while fighting the robots or avoiding them. But at the same time, you need to find more ammunition, more items, more guns. And here are the famous boxes. So after a while you just get used to the boxes and only search the boxes. You hear a little point like that when you are near one. You hear that loot symbol. What was that? A hunting rifle silencer. Great, can you use it on a shotgun? No, you can't. Well, I heard some loot. Yeah, that was everything. So, after you search this very, very big location, I mean, it will take you probably about 10 minutes to search this location. And you'll only get more bullets, more health kits, and maybe a new gun. But this will become so tedious, I mean, imagine doing this for 2 hours. What's in here? A big nothing. Because you don't have any backpack or crates. Sorry for the long video, but I just wanted to show you the first hour of gameplay. And many people say you didn't play the game enough, you didn't see enough, but at this point I think in about a week or two everyone will agree that this game has some real problems. And only by talking about the problems will you solve the problems. Again, such a huge map, but it's empty. Ah, let's listen to that beautiful music again. Ah, that makes me happy. Notice how it changes with the distance. How can you have so many good elements in such a bad game? I don't know. It's behind me. Again, oh, let's go up, because... why not? Let's end this in here. So let's end the game how with the most anticipated feature of it. Throwing the radios with batteries on them and listen to the music. It cancels one another. Okay, sorry for this video being so long. See you next time. Bye bye.